Communication is such a powerful tool. Of course, every word is important, but there are some words that are highly powerful, highly influential compared to rest of the words. Today in this video, I'm going to talk to you about six such important words in English language which can influence the people that you are communicating with. Now, these words that I'm going to talk to you about are words that are proved to be more effective and powerful based on various studies across the globe. So let's get started. Now imagine being able to enter into a person's subconscious mind. Imagine being able to get an yes from your co-worker or your boss whenever you have a reasonable request. I just gave you out the first word there, and the word is imagine. Imagine is such a powerful word. It's more like a backdoor entry to a person's subconscious mind. Naturally, human beings are not more favorable towards change. So when you ask someone for something that requires them to make a little bit of change in their routine or their lifestyle, the natural tendency is more to say a no than a yes. So when you want something from someone, you have to first make them live that moment, live that situation that you are going to create for them. So what happens when you use this word imagine? You are entering into somebody's subconscious mind. You are getting them to a place where you want them to be. You are breaking down their natural defense mechanism. You are breaking down their tendency to say no to your request by making them live in your request in first place. So use imagine appropriately whenever required. Before moving on to the second word, let me ask you to do something for me. Notice in which hand you have your phone right now. Notice if it is your right hand or your left hand. Your phone is not in your hand right now, then notice where your phone is. Did you do all of that for me? That is the power of the word notice. When you ask people, when you tell to people to notice something, they always do. Before I asked you to notice if your phone was in your right hand or your left hand or it was just lying on the table somewhere, you were not bothered. You were not bothered at all about your phone or your hand. But the moment I used that word notice, you thought it was important. You responded, you reacted to it. So whatever follows this word notice, the sentence that you're going to talk after this word notice, it gains significance. People assume that it is very important and they tend to listen, they tend to react to it. The third word is perhaps my favorite power word in English language. We don't even realize, we use it a number of times in a day, but we don't even realize this. And the word is because. So whenever we hear this word because, we assume that whatever follows next is a good enough reason. There is a wonderful study performed by Ellen Langer at Harvard. This study proves how effective the word because can be in a conversation. Once Ellen went to a group of people standing in a line to make photocopies. People were waiting in front of a Xerox machine to make photocopies. So this is how the experiment went. The first time Ellen approached this group of people standing in the line, she went and told them this. Excuse me, may I have the Xerox machine please? I have 5 pages. In this scenario, almost 60% of the people let her cut the line and use the Xerox machine first. After some time, she approached the group of people, the people who were standing in the line, with the same request. But this time, the sentence had a little twist. So this is what she asked. I have 5 pages. May I use the Xerox machine please because I am in a rush. This time 94% of the people agreed to her request and helped her cut the line and move forward. After few minutes, for the third time, she went and approached the line with the same request and she even used the word because, but there was a slight change in the sentence. So here is what she said the third time. Excuse me, I have 5 pages. May I have the Xerox machine because I have to make copies. This time, 93% of the people agreed and they helped her cut the line and move forward. Did you see the difference here between her second request and the third request? At least the second time, she had a valid reason. She followed the word because with a valid reason. But the third time, she just said, I want to make photocopies. And every person in that line was standing only to make photocopies. That was not even a valid reason. It was a silly, simple reason. But still, people agreed to let her move forward. That's what happens when you use the word because. Naturally, we are wired to assume that whatever follows this word because is a good enough reason. So sometimes even if the reason is silly, people don't really listen to it. All they hear is this word because. So the next time around when you have a request to make to your boss or your co-workers, add this word because and follow it with a strong reason. Attach a reason to it. People are more likely to say an yes to you. The fourth important word that we are going to see is you. You is such a significant word. It's such an important word in a conversation. Because these days we tend to use a lot of I in our conversation. I was thinking about it. I thought maybe we could do this. I was thinking about calling you. There's a lot of I in our conversation. And somewhere the person who is opposite to us, who is listening to us, just loses the concentration, just loses the interest. But the moment you start using this word you a lot, it instantly gets the attention. It grabs the attention of the person who is listening to you. Because now it is all about them. And that's what people want. They want that significance. They want to feel important. They want to feel that power. So when you give them that, they tend to listen to you more. Let us look at an example here. Suppose you want to talk to someone for 5 minutes and you know the person is really busy. If you go and tell them, hey, I was hoping that we could just catch up for 5 minutes and talk, the chances of you getting turned down are high. But at the same time, if you go and tell the person this, you seem to be really busy right now. Do you think it'll be possible for you to squeeze in like 5 or 10 minutes to have a discussion? So when the person hears this word you, he or she is more likely to help you listen to you. So now coming to our fifth important word. We use this word so many times in our everyday conversation without even realizing what an important word this is. The word is and. Let me give you an example here. Let me tell you how this word and can make a lot of difference in a sentence. So here comes the example. I have given you 5 important words in English language, but there is one more word to go. Now look at the same sentence in another way. I have given you 5 important words in English language and there is one more important word to go. So you heard both the examples. There is only one difference between these two examples. In the first example, I have used the word but. In the second example, I have used the word and. Do you see the difference here? In the sentence which has but in the middle, you almost neglected the first half of the sentence. Whatever followed in the second half only sticks to your mind, stays in your mind. Whereas in the second example, where I have used the word and, both parts of the sentences will stick to your mind, will stay in your mind. Because this word and means both the parts of the sentences are equally important. For instance, if you are giving a feedback to your subordinate or your co-worker, instead of saying something like, you did a great job last time, but more challenging work is coming your way, say this. You did a great job last time and more challenging work is coming your way. This way you're saying that both things are equally important. He or she did a great job, that is important. More challenging work is coming their way, that is important. You are not negating one part of the sentence. You are making both parts of the sentence equally important. And that's what powerful communication is all about. So the sixth important word that we will be seeing in this video is the word. It's a pause. Pause is such an effective tool in communication. An effective pause at the right moment, at the right time, is as important, is as powerful as any word. For instance, when I paused there for a moment, a lot of thoughts came in your mind. You were filling your mind with so many things, but you were so looking forward to what I was going to say next. So when you pause for a moment or two and then you follow it up with something interesting, it registers in the mind of the audience or the person that you are communicating with very effectively. So take that pause whenever appropriate. When you are going to suggest something important, take that pause. Pause for a moment or two, not more than that. Imagine being able to learn something useful like this every week. Interesting, right? If you want to do that, do you notice that subscribe button below? Yeah, click on that. If you like this video, give it a thumbs up because it'll mean a lot to me. Why don't we try something fun? Use these 5 powerful words, create a sentence or a paragraph and leave it in the comment section below. I'll see you next Thursday, as you know. Until then, bye and be well.